Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this tutorial, we are going to create party streamers and we're going to use brushes in order to create them. So you can draw them in any direction, in any length that you like. We're going to make them like this with this golden look. So let's start this. I'm going to start with a straight line. And let's just apply a black color to it, like so. And then we're going to use Effect, Distort and Transform and Zigzag. And let's make this a larger size and more ridges per segment. And this does not look a lot like a streamer, so let's make them smooth. And now we're getting close. So let's OK that, and let's expand the appearance like so. And then we're going to move that to the side, pressing the Alt and the Shift key in order to make an exact horizontal move to the side like so. And now we need to connect the tops and bottoms, which is simple because thankfully Illustrator placed anchor points exactly there, so we just need to take the line segment tool and then draw from this anchor to that one. The highlights are caused by the smart guides that I have selected, and you turn them on here in the view menu. And now let's just connect that one as well, and then down here, and let's make just one other. Like so. So that's it. We need to select these and then go to the Shape Builder tool and let's build shapes. And let's do it like this and then click that one, do these and this one. We do not need more than that, and the other paths can be put into the bin, and that's what we need here. Now, this needs to be cut in order to match, and we need to figure out the place where to cut it, which should be a place where it doesn't matter a lot. So let's just select this and go to the direct selection tool, and you see up there is a point that we can then again use like so, and this time draw a vertical line, and this one has the same point, so that's our repeat. And now we can use this here and go to object path and then divide objects below and do the same with this one, and also divide the objects below. And again, we need to delete this and delete that. And now we can think of coloring it. And for this one, it's simple. We can just go to Window, Swatches, and in here we have some gradients. And there are metals here. And we can just apply some nice metal like so. And then we need those for the others as well, but it will be quite difficult to match that gradient. So we're going to use a helper object and let's apply a different gradient here like that one. Now these gradients need to be adjusted, so I'm going to get rid of that stroke and then use the gradient tool and draw this line, or maybe let's draw it from here to there. That might be nicer like this. That's cool. Do the same with this one here and draw this. And this is going to be in the shadow, so we need to change this. I'm going to double click this one and then let's go into CMYK color mode and make the thing darker here. Let's add some yellow and some magenta and make this darker so we have the impression of that shadow. Let's add some more magenta to it like this. Okay. And down here, maybe we should get some shadow as well. I'm going to drag that. And you see when you press the shift key, then all of them move together like this. That's nice. And now we can also get rid of that stroke. And then we cannot use gradients inside of brushes. So we need to expand those gradients. Now, in order to do that, you select that and go to Object, Expand. And then, of course, just the fill, there's no stroke to expand, and we get specify and the number of objects. Now, this is usually set to something like 250, which is way too much for brushes. You want to get away with as few objects as even possible, so 60 or maybe even just 50. You might want to try that out, and it depends on the size that you're going to use this in. So let's try 50. And you see, we need to zoom in quite far in order to see the steps. Let's do it for this as well, and let's go to Object Expand and do 50. That's nice. And now we need to, of course, get them in shape. So I'm going to move it here and I'm going to arrange and send to back. And then again, I'm making a copy by dragging with the Alt key pressed. And let's take a look at it in outline view, like so. And yes, this fits. Okay. So let's just select them both and go to Object, Clipping Mask, Make. And let's do the same over here. So let's select it like so. I'm using the shortcut, which is the 7. So it's Command 7 or Control 7 on Windows. Now, these will still not work. So when we go into Outline View, you see these are all still there. So we need to expand those clipping masks. So I'm going to Window Pathfinder and then just this is selected and then click on crop and again crop and another time and crop this. And let's go into outline view and you see this is nice. So let's go to Window Brushes and select this all. And just drag it inside there and make a pattern brush, like so. We do not need that corner element. There won't be any corners. So let's go to OK. And then we can try that out by just drawing some line and apply that brush. That is nice. And then you can further enhance this by using the width tool and you see make it larger here, make it smaller here and adjust that to your needs and make a nice party streamer. Maybe you want to try out a different design for your streamers and then you can use the basic design with the zigzag effect and then build the shapes and just color them with a solid color and add some shapes to it. So in this case, I have just drawn circles like so and put these circles in here. And then you can just go to the free transform tool and just distort that slightly like so, and this might be already too much, so just slightly, and then adjust that so that it looks like perspective, and then put that on here, and again select all of them, drag it into the brushes panel, make the pattern brush, uncheck that corner element, and then you're done. And you can use that as well. So let's just drag that here and apply the other design, which looks nice as well. So there are unlimited possibilities of drawing streamers.